Welcome back to the channel. In this video, we are going to see exploiting Ruby deserialization using a documented gadget chain. In this lab, we are going to see a case where sometimes it's difficult to find out a code to exploit the server to avoid the time to in order to get the script done. We can search sometime some ints or some library that we can face during the surfing of the web server, and usually we can get some works made by other people who are trying to exploit a different type of server or a similar one, and we can use the same code in order to succeed the lab or perform an attack. First, we need just to retrieve the cookie session from the my account request, because as usual here inside there is stored the cookie session, which inside there is encoded the object, where in this case there is the username and access token. But after the exploit through Ruby, we will insert inside the script. As you can see, if we search on Google for the hint, we can find out that there is an article published by Vags in which he was trying to build an exploit in Ruby to find out all the ID inside the web server. But in this case, we can use the same script, but we need to modify one line in order to insert the command that we need. So we can insert at the place of the ID, the remove, and the directory where is located the morale.txt file. One other thing that we need to modify is the puts, which is similar to print on Python and system.out on Java, and we need to insert the base64-encode64 and the payload. This function will encode the payload in base64, as you can see. If you are curious to see what is the code, we can comment this line and insert puts payload. This will output the code without encoding it, and as you can see, this is the code that will be stored into the cookie session. Now let's retrieve again the cookie session encoded. In this case, we need to wrap it and erase the new space character and new line. We can perform this with the pipe command and tr-d and the two special characters. As you can see, now we have the cookie session wrapped in the right way. So if we insert it here, we will be able to succeed on the app. Now let's insert it into the cookie session. We can insert it in a normal way, or even in a URL encoded way, because in some case you will not be able to succeed the lab if you don't URL encode the request. If you enjoyed the video, please leave a like and subscribe. See you in the future.